Hi, this is Sarah with How I Pinch a Penny, and I'm going to be showing you how I make my black bean burger at home. Instead of buying them frozen in a 4-pack at the grocery store, I take a can of black beans, rinsed, and this cost me about 50 cents. And then I have here about a third cup of crushed pretzels. They are salted. This is the only salt that will be added to the recipe other than the salt that already comes in a can of beans. And then I'm gonna take a fork and just mash them up. It's a pretty quick process. You can use a food processor, but I like big chunks of bean in my black bean burger. I don't like the mash, mushy, baby food consistency. So I'm about a quarter of the way there. It would be faster if you used a food processor, but then you have the cleanup of that and you don't have the full beans. I find that you lose the full bean with a food processor. You could reserve some off to the side and add later. That's another option if you don't like feel like doing the whole fork thing. But there you go. See, that's what we're looking for. That's the consistency I like. And then I'm going to take one egg. This is going to act as your binder. It's going to give you extra added protein as well. Eggs are a great, inexpensive source of protein. And there you see, it's loosened up a bit. And now we're going to add flavor. This is where you can get kind of fun. I'm using my salsa that I canned earlier this year. Store-bought salsa would be great. I have a salsa verde, the green salsa with the tomatillas. I like that one. This one happens to have more black beans in it, and I think it also has a little bit of corn. So I'm going to do 2 tablespoons of that. It's not an exact science. You saw I just kind of tossed them in there. So that's going to give us some flavor. And then you go ahead and dump in your third cup of crushed pretzels. I like Snyder's of Hanover. They are a local company for me. I enjoy when people shop local, shop fresh. So Snyder's is one that I use. I'm able to get them at my BJ's and so that it's in a bulk. So there you go. That's what your black bean burger is going to look like. You're going to let sit for about a minute to have the pretzels absorb a little bit of the extra moisture. And then we're going to make some patties and cook them up. I have a nonstick skillet heating on my stove. I'm going to add maybe a teaspoon of peanut oil. I like peanut oil because it has a higher smoke point than olive oil whenever I'm doing a little bit of browning in a pan. The burger mixture is ready to go. I'm going to take out 25% of it. Make it into a ball, giving it a little squeeze as you go. And then you're gonna flatten it out. So it's gonna look like a burger. The more consistent it is in thickness around, the more consistent it will be in its heating. We're gonna spread our oil out a little bit. And that's all the heating it took on the pan, and we'll lay that in there, and then we're going to flip that in just a couple of minutes. Here we are 2 minutes later, and we're going to take a peek at our burger to see how it's doing. Yes, we have great crust on the underside. Take our spatula, flip it over. There we go. And then we're going to let that cook for another 2 minutes.